everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I've seen this ethnicity tag around on YouTube for a little while now, and I've seen some of my YouTube friends do it, and also some of you guys have asked me to do it as well, and I just thought, why not? It seems like a really cool and fun tag to do, so I really wanted to get involved in this and also just get in touch with my roots a little bit as well. And also, it's another great way for you guys to get to know me a little bit more than you already do. So there's not that many questions, there's about six. So I'm just gonna jump straight in there and let's go. Okay, so I was born in London, England, and I'm actually from West London, and I always have been, but ethnicity wise, I am actually Indian, and I'm a Sikh Punjabi person. My mum, she comes from, well, she was born in Kenya, Nairobi, and my dad is from Punjab in India. Now that can confuse people when I say that my mum's actually from Kenya, because then they ask me if my mum is African and if I am mixed race, and I'm not. I am one whole Indian person. There are a lot of Indians in Kenya, if you didn't already know that already. But yeah, she just happens to be from Kenya instead of India. And yeah, my mum's Indian, my dad's Indian. I am whole Indian, and we're one big Indian family. The last time I visited India, I think I was about 15, and I'd gone there to do a little Sikh pilgrimage, and I say little, it was actually rather big and long and very, very difficult. I wouldn't say I'm like an orthodox Sikh, because I'm not. I cut my hair, I eat meat, and I'm not practicing, but I do believe in my religion strongly. And so yeah, I went on this Sikh pilgrimage with my mum and my sister and a few other family members, and it was just such an amazing experience. It was kind of like going up the mountains by the Himalayas and that kind of thing, and it was very challenging, but it was breathtaking at the same time, and also very rewarding to go up to the top of the mountain and see a temple that has been built there for years and years and years. And it was just gorgeous. So yeah, I went there when I was 15, and that was my last experience. And also I'd gone to visit a lot of family members that were in India too. So that was really lovely to see everyone. Originally, myself and my family are all from the north of India in Punjab. And like I said before, that's where my dad was born. Even though my mum wasn't born in Punjab, a lot of her family and her parents and whatnot were all from there originally as well. So that's why I'm Punjabi. Oh, this one is hard, because I absolutely love Indian food. There is so much variety, so many different flavors. Just, oh my God, I love, love, love Indian food. And I love Punjabi food, especially just because I think out of all the Indian, different types of Indian food that there is, because there's so many different types of Indians as well, I think Punjabi food, not being biased, is the best, because I feel like we've just got the most flavor, more variety, we eat a lot of meat, and I love meat, and yeah, I love, love, love Punjabi Indian food. So I would say my favorite has to be like a standard chicken curry, and my mum makes the best chicken curry, hands down, so damn good. So chicken curry and rice, and I like my rice to have peas in and like vegetables, and yummy, yummy, yummy. And then for a vegetarian option, I like, it's called rajma. And if you don't know what that means, it's basically a red kidney bean, which we make a curry out of, and I love that. Okay, so for this one, I think absolutely every single Indian household has got this, or something very, very similar to it. And it's actually a little spice tray that we can keep all of our spices in, because Indians love, love, love their food. We're renowned for our food and love of food and giving food, as well as eating food and making food. So yeah, we have so many different spices, Every Indian household has one of these little trays to separate all the spices so you don't get it all mixed up, even though it's gonna get all mixed up and thrown in together anyway. But yeah, definitely think everybody has got one of those or something along those lines. I do try. I don't really feel the need to speak it that much anymore. I can say a few odd sentences here and there, and I can have a good basic conversation with somebody in my language, which is Punjabi. But I just don't really feel the need to speak it, just because everybody speaks English in my family, and even all of my family that are in India, they all speak and understand English very well. Also, as a child, when I was growing up, when I should have been learning to speak English, my grandma, at the age of 77, she decided to do a diploma in English and learn it. So I just found that the perfect opportunity for me to get out of learning to speak Punjabi and practice her English with her. So I would just speak to her in English and make her speak back to me in English. So I was kind of cheating, but I was trying to help her out at the same time. So yeah, I never really felt the need to speak Punjabi that much. And I don't really need to speak it that much anymore, which is kind of sad, because I would love my children to learn to speak Punjabi and understand it just as much as I do. I understand Punjabi 100%, but I just can't speak it very well. So that's the tag all done with. I would absolutely love to know what ethnicity you are and what your favourite food from your ethnicity is, because I would love to try it. I absolutely love food, so please, please, please do share. Also, if you've got any video suggestions for me, throw them down below in the comment section and I will check them out. And oh, and I'm tagging all of you guys to get involved in this one, because it's a pretty cool tag. Please, please, please give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video. Mwah. Bye.